To hitch a ride to play American Legion baseball. And then a boating accident in the 1940s culminates 50 years later for Jay Frederick with a surprising discovery. Let's start the night in 1936 with Shervena Grubbs, her twin sister, and their daddy on the train in Couldn't Sleep a Wink.
It is still vivid in our minds, the large crowds, the marching bands, and cheers, and the President of the United States in his big fine car with his long cigar holder up in his hand, waving in the air and smiling to everyone. Dignitaries and fans from all over the state were there. The year was 1936, and this was probably the biggest event in Arkansas. Daddy had a thought it would be a good idea for him to go see President Franklin D. Roosevelt in Little Rock. Yes, Sheriff. With the fine idea to take my five-year-old twin sister, Shervena, and me. We were the first set of Thompson twins because Mother and Daddy had twin baby boys for each of us when we were nine. We couldn't sleep a wink the night before we left. We were so excited. For two little giggly girls, we talked all night in anticipation of our first train trip and to meet our president. Sister, I just can't believe the president is coming all the way down here to see us. Our mother and daddy had a mercantile store, and our Uncle Fred and Aunt Jeanette had the only shoe store in Russellville, Arkansas. We always had the newest and finest of everything. Not a lot of extras, but everyday things, and things for Sunday school and church only. The next morning, Mother dressed us up in our beautiful Sunday clothes, our yellow dresses, with our big matching bows in our hair. Our daddy had cut our hair in a luster brown hairstyle, which was real popular at the time. It had bangs, and it was shingled up the back and named for Buster Brown. He was a mascot who visited shoe stores. Daddy insisted on us sitting real still. When he got to the neckline, it tickled, and we just wiggled away. We had our black patent leather Roman sandals. You had to fasten them with a button hook. We can see it now. Of course, the mother couldn't find the button book, as always. morning, bright and early, to board the train from Russellville to Little Rock, approximately 75 miles, with several stops in towns in between. We opened the windows at each stop and got black cinders in our eyes every time. We had to see everybody getting on the train. It must have been hard for Daddy to keep us seated. We were already little helpers in the store. In the train, we ran up and down the aisles. Are you all twins? Yes. We're with our daddy, but our mother is taking care of the store. Where do you live? How old are you? Travelers talk to us, and we love to talk. Daddy watched for a while, and then he would get grumpy. Okay, girls, that's enough. Oh, Daddy, we said as we shuffled off our shuffle ball chain. Daddy said, do you think our president will want us to tap dance for him? Yes. He might, sissies, as he patted us on the shoulder and monitored for us to take our seat. And that is why you need to be rested when you meet him. For a few minutes, we'd be really, really good. As the train pulled in to the capital city, we were all eyes. Men in suits and hats and women in beautiful dresses of satin and stylish hats and high-heeled shoes. Boy, we couldn't wait to get big and wear high heels and beautiful jewelry. Daddy had one twin on each hand, and all he had to do was squeeze one hand, and that was the signal to stop what we were doing. We wanted to go everywhere, and we knew if we didn't be real good, Daddy wouldn't let us go with him. He talked to us about how important it was to be at this event. We probably didn't understand, but we knew it was an important day. Daddy talked to us all throughout the day. Now, girls, this is going to be a really big day. A lot of people never get to see their president, but you're real special getting to see the president of the United States. We were five, and we got to ride the train for the very first time. We got to see our president for the first time. And after the speeches, we went nearby to a bar with our dad. Yes, a beer joint. Girls, do you want to drink the foam off of Daddy's beer? Yes! Oh, Daddy, please! We didn't know what beer was. He held it, and each of us drank the foam. Both of us liked it, and what an experience for two five-year-olds. A bit of history, a bit of fun, and a bit of beer.